Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'd like to take a moment to announce our sixth graders as they take this home field for the last time. We want to recognize the hard work and dedication of our players and their families they put in to each season. First up, we have our cheerleaders.
How do I show you I have a
First up, we have Elise Hine, who is escorted by her mom, Ashley, and dad, Robert. Her favorite memory of cheer are the game days. She's been participating on the cheer squad for 2 years. She likes to play volleyball as well as cheerlead. And as she moves on to the seventh grade, she hopes to continue cheering on the junior high team. Next up is Cadence Hill, being escorted by mom and dad, Brittany and JD. Her favorite memory from cheer is stunting. She's been in cheer for 2 years. She likes volleyball as well. And when she gets to seventh grade, she hopes to make the volleyball team and the cheer team. Abigail Kushner is being escorted by Sydney and Anthony. Her favorite memory is meeting new people and competing on the competition team. She's been involved with cheer for 3 years, and when she gets to seventh grade, she hopes to be a junior high cheerleader. Gabby Mitchin is being escorted by her parents, Leisha and Nathan. Her favorite cheer memory is stunting. She's been on the cheer squad for 5 years. She also enjoys playing volleyball and wrestling. And in seventh grade, she hopes to get stronger for volleyball and cheer and get better in math. Mary Ann Riley, being escorted by parents Don and Sherry. Her favorite cheer memory is learning it all for the first time. This is her first year with the cheerleading squad. She also likes to play basketball. And for seventh grade, she hopes to make the junior high cheer squad. Up next is Ava Rodriguez. She's being escorted by Jasmine and Eduardo. Her favorite cheer memory is learning new dances and how to stunt and having fun with her cheer friends. She has been involved with cheer for 2 years. She also plays basketball. And in seventh grade, she hopes to continue to get good grades and do more sports like soccer and volleyball. Riley Rogers, being escorted by her big brother, Blake. This is her first year cheerleading. Her favorite memory is her first year of cheerleading. She has cheerleaded for 4 years, and in seventh grade, she just hopes to keep on cheering. Adrina Rosenall, escorted by mom, Amy, and dad, Eugene. Her favorite cheer memory is being a flyer. She has been in cheer for 6 years, and she hopes to make the seventh grade cheer squad. Savannah Rudd, being escorted by mom Tabitha and dad Brian. Her favorite cheer memory is making new friends. She's been on cheer for one season, and in seventh grade, she hopes to get good grades and make the cheer team. Haley Shaw, being escorted by mom Katrina and dad Adam. Her favorite cheer memory is being supported and meeting new friends. She's cheered for 4 years, and she also does band. In seventh grade, she hopes to continue to succeed at her work in school and the things she loves. Leah Sylvester, being escorted by Heather, mom, and older sister Olivia. Her favorite cheer memory is learning to do stunts and being a flyer. She's been in cheer for 3 years, and in seventh grade, she hopes to make the cheer squad and not to get ran over by the high school kids. Taylor Thompson, being escorted by parents Tracy and Ryan and brother Tyler. Her favorite cheer memory are the youth nights. She's cheered for 4 years and also plays volleyball. In seventh grade, she hopes to make the cheer team. Lucas Chirac, being escorted by mom, dad, and bonus dad, Don, Troy, and Jose. His favorite memory of football is playing with his friends. He's been involved for 4 years, and he also likes playing basketball. In seventh grade, he hopes to see some wins on the field. Keith Croston, being escorted by dad, Christopher Croston, mom, Shar Croston, and sister, Macy Croston. Favorite memories of football are his friends and catching his first touchdown. He's been involved with football for 3 years and also plays basketball. In seventh grade, he hopes to stay in football. Jonathan Carter, being escorted by parents John and Stacy. His favorite football member is laying out a kid. And how many years he's played, this is his first year on the football team. He also does baseball and soccer. In seventh grade, he hopes to get good grades and play sports. Liam Grabsky is being escorted by mom Rebecca and Michael. Favorite memory is to take away a fumble. He's played for 5 years on the football team, and he also plays baseball. In seventh grade, he hopes to continue on with football and remain an honor roll student. Jonathan Halterman, being escorted by Father Dustin and Mom Megan. His favorite memory of football is running the ball and catching passes during spring play. He's been on the football team for 7 years, and he also likes to play baseball and basketball. In seventh grade, he hopes to get straight A's. Finn Hurst, being escorted by Austin and Spencer Hurst. His favorite memory of football is the feeling of winning. He's been involved for 6 years, but also plays basketball, baseball, and flag football. In seventh grade, he hopes to keep it improving and get 15 sacks. Samson Long, being escorted by Mom and Dad. His favorite memory is scoring his first touchdown to win our first game in a long time. He's been on the football team for 3 years, but he also plays basketball and baseball. In seventh grade, he hopes to help make Springfield great again. Lucas Seidel, being escorted by Mom and Dad. His favorite memory is getting to be on the Spartans team. He's played for 1 year and also enjoys playing basketball. In seventh grade, he's looking to make the football team again. Aiden Steinmetz, being escorted by Aaron and Deborah Walsh. His favorite memory is playing football. He's been on the team for 2 years, and in seventh grade, he hopes to make good grades and to play other sports. Kamal Trammell is being escorted by Kyler, Dad. His favorite football memory is winning their first game. He's been involved for 2 years, and he also likes to play baseball and basketball. In seventh grade, he has high hopes for math and football. George Thorne is being escorted by Mom Sharon, stepdad Justin, and sister Leilana. His favorite memory of football is playing with Hunter Eby. He's been on the team for 3 years, and in seventh grade, he hopes to get better at football. Blake Young, being escorted by mother Kaylin and brother Zayden. His favorite football memory is his first home game win. He's been on the team for 6 years and also enjoys playing baseball and basketball. His hopes for seventh grade are to pass.
If everyone would please rise, we have one final player on our team. As many of you know, number 17, Hunter Eby, was a member of the Springfield Spartan Youth football team. He was a varsity player, and this would have been his final home game. Tragically, we lost him back in June to Lake Erie. His jersey, though, because he is still a member of our team, is being escorted across the field today by his father, Sam, his mom, Diane, his sister, Charlotte, and his little sister, Amelia. Let's get a big round of applause for all of our sixth graders. This is their last home game. Now for your 2024 Springfield Spartan varsity team, led by head coach Duke Johnson. We have number 19, Liam Grabsky, number 24, Lucas Schirach, number 4, Camille Trammell, number 13, Aiden Steinmetz, number 1, Lucas Sedell, number 2, Finn Hurst, number 11, Jonathan Halterman, number 26, Jonathan Carter, number 44, Carter Summers, number 27, Samson Long, number 18, George Thorne, number 15, Blake Young, number 33, Keith Frosten, number 29, Ezra Saw, number 7, Blake Stewart, number 0, Gage Howell, number 35, Tate Hicks, number 32, Cooper Cisterna, number 36, Connor Guy, number 45, Jackson Hackney, number 6, Joseph Bohannon Jr., number 8, Jacoby Peoples, number 34, Desmond Norvell, number 31, Ozias Tepus, number 4, Alexander Perkins, number 95, Lazar Taylor, number 25, Joseph McCutcheon, number 54, Zachary Rager, number 22, Quinn Lewis, number 39, Dylan Johnson, and number 28, Jensen Vang. That's your 2024 Springfield Spartan varsity team. Looks like the Spartans won the coin toss, opted to defer to the second half.
Let's go.
And Derek's going to start with the football. They'll have first and 10 from their own 35. I'd like to remind everybody that this is a non-smoking facility. The use of any and all tobacco products is strictly prohibited. This is school property. That means there is absolutely no smoking, vaping, e-pens of any kind. We do have trash cans located throughout the facility, so please listen to if trash is ending up in the receptacles. And he snapped his D-man, number four is going to be the ball player. He runs into a couple of Spartans, and he is stopped. Looks like number two is Ben Hurston on the tackle for the Spartans. Game of one is going to bring up second and nine for the D-man. We will have a 50-50 going around during the game. Proceeds of the 50-50 go to benefit the Springfield Spartan Youth Football and Cheer Program. The winner will be drawn in the fourth quarter. Got a penalty against the Spartans here. It's going to be an offside. Clean snap for the G-men who are looking to run. Nice tackle by the Spartans. Looks like number 19, Liam Grabsky, on the tackle, but it was just enough for the G-men first down. Our concession stand is open. We've got hot food, cold drinks, and there might still be some ices in there if you're getting warm out there. It's a nice hot day and a beautiful day for football.
Let's go,
it's going to be offside against the Spartans. Straight ahead.
There you go, Finn.
Number two, Finn Hurst with the tackle for the Spartans. 5 yard gain on post number up, first and ten. There by the Spartans after a 5 yard gain, going to be a second down. G-man number four is going to be a ball player. He's looking to get outside. He's got a little room to run. Number seven, Blake Stewart's going to be a first down too. He's going to be dropped down by the Spartans, but it's enough for a G-man first down. That's going to back him up. It's going to be a 10-yard penalty. Replay first down. So G-men will have first and 20 from the 40.
Stay by me. Looks like number 16 in the back row. He's going down to number 10 and 4. That's Lucas Sharrock with the tackle for the Spartans. Bring that 2 on the play, going to bring up 2nd and 18. Going to snap to the D-man, number 35, looking to pass, passes up, and through the hands, passes in the incomplete, going to bring up 3rd down. Big 3rd down opportunity here for the Spartan defense. He's looking to get to the right, running hard, and he's going to be met by a couple of Spartans. Looks like we have a flag on the play. Looks like we've got a face mask against the defense. It's going to be, it's going to be a 5-yard penalty. Clean snap for the G-man, looking to run the football.
Lucas, shut that down!
Looks like number 4, ball carrier for the G-man, trying to stop short, giving up 4th and short for the G-man. Strong here to get the stop on 4th down. Let's hear it for him. He's not the junior number 4. He's going to run the football. He's trying to get to the outside. He's going to get enough for a first down. Still on his feet, and it looks like he's going to get in for a G-man touchdown. We've got an official timeout for a couple of injured Spartans on the field. Nice round of applause for our Spartans back on their feet. So after a touchdown, the G-men are going to line up. Looks like they're going to try for a PAT here.
Hold that line, Sports and hold that line. Hold that line, Sports and hold that line. Hold that line, Sports and hold
that line. Number 11's kick is up. And it is no good, so the extra point attempt is no good. After a touchdown, we're going to score 3-0, goes for G-men 6, with 2:54 left to play in the first quarter. We're going to see the Spartan offense take the field. First down, the Spartans have a clean snap and a good handoff, running straight ahead for a couple of yards. Football ball number 0. Gage Powell, the ball carrier for the Spartans. Picking up the 4 yards, can bring up 2nd and 6. And snap for the Spartans, looking to hand it off and run straight ahead. Short game on the play, it looks like number 13, Aiden Stein, that's the ball carrier for the Spartans. He's going to bring up 35. Snap his brain, number 15, Blake Williams, and keeps this one. He's trying to get around to the edge, he's still on his feet, and he's going to have for a Spartan first down. He's going to get pushed all down to the back of the back of James 39. But that is Spartan first down. First and 10 from the G-man 49-yard line. Clean snap and good handoff to number 26, Jonathan Carter. He's still on his feet and looking for some room to run. He's playing a nice play, got a nice step on. Still on his feet. He's still working his way through, trying to increase his win number. He's finally going to be dropped down. They do have a flag on the play. Unfortunately, this one's coming back. It looks like we've got a hold against the offense.
Hey, get your helmet on. We're ready to go. Hey, get your helmet on and come on up here.
Come on, Gage.
So apparently he's going to back enough 10 yards, but we're going to play first down. So we're going to have first and 20 from the Springfield 40.
Let's go!
We're going to start with the Spartans number 15, right there, looking to run it, and he's going to be stopped after about a 1 yard gain. With 10 seconds left in the quarter, it looks like we're going to get a water break here.
Hey, it's not halftime. Get a drink and let's go.
And that's the end of the first quarter. We have a score of Springfield Spartan 0, Northfield Demon 6, but Spartans are driving. I thank our sponsors, Uncle Tito's Mexican Grill, Twin Peaks Roofing, Shelly's Hair Nail Salon, Presley Meats, and Sweet City Car Wash. We want to thank them for their support this season. I'd like to take a moment to thank all of our volunteers. Everybody in town are out here, from the officials to the handgun, the ladies working the concession stand, coaches. Everybody out here is volunteering today. We appreciate all their hard work. It's been a hot day and a long day, but it's been a great day of football out here. Our concession stand is open, but I do believe they're running low on some things. So if you're getting hungry, thirsty, or you want something to cool off with, you might want to come see them soon.
Hey, get a drink, get your helmet on, and come on back out here.
Let's see it, D-Lon! Watch the ball! Stay home!
First down, we've got Rick Scott, but Rick Scott, number 400 Buckley for the team, and he's looking to get outside. Nope, he's on the street for a couple of shorts. This is number 24, Lucas Scott, and number 19, Liam Bradford, with the running in the tackle.
Hey, nice job, Liam!
They will run on the post and bring out 2nd and 9. Now, just so that we're down to our last ice cream drumstick in the concession stand, so if you want to cool off, you better get over here fast. Spartan getting back up on his feet. It's two-man football. They've got 1st and 10 from midfield.
Watch the ball!
Green snap for the G-man. Number four is going to be a ball carrier. He's going to keep this one. Trying to get outside of the Spartans who are going to meet him. Looks like a 3-yard gain on the play. He's going to bring out second down. Second down, got a clean snap for the G-man, looking to run straight ahead. Big third down opportunity here for the Spartans to get a stop. Got third and a long run for the D-man. Clean snap for the G-man, looking to run straight ahead. Gonna have enough for a first down as they get tackled by a host of Spartans. Looks like number zero, Gage Howell, is the first one to him. Low snap for the G-man's crowd, and he is off to the races. Looking to get to the edge. Going to be met by number four, Mel Campbell. Still on his feet, though, and running through the sideline. Looks like he's going to get in for a G-man touchdown. G-men are going to line up for the extra point attempt. Clean snap, looking to pass, passes up and caught. That extra point attempt is going to be good for two. With 2:37 left in the half, the Spartan offense is going to take the field. They'll have first and 10 from their own 35. Spartan offense is on the field. They got first and 10 from their own 35. Clean snap and a good handoff to number 26, Jonathan Carter. He's met immediately, though, in the backfield. He's still fighting, but he's going to be brought down after about a 5-yard loss. Going to bring up second down for the Spartans.
Queen's snap is Spartan. Number 15 is trying to keep this one, but he's going to be met in the backfield and drop down. Can bring up 3rd and 16 for the Spartans. Clean snap for the Spartans. Number 15 is looking to pass. Pass is up. And that pass is going to fall incomplete. Can bring up 4th down. Fourth down, Spartans are going to have to punt the football. Number 35, Tate Pitts, is back for the punt. Punt is up. And it is caught by number 4 for the G-men. G-men are going to take over the football. They'll have 1st and 10 for the Spartan 39-yard line. With 1:05 left in the first half. Stick around for the halftime show as our cheerleaders take the field to perform their halftime routines.
Let's go, get ready, get down.
Aiden.
Outside.
Clean snap for the G-men who are looking to pass. Pass is up and caught. That pass was caught by number 4, the receiver. And that is good for a G-men touchdown. Timeout called by the G-men. First and 10, G-men are looking to pass. Pass is up, and it is going to fall short, incomplete.
Hey, lady.
It's going to bring up 2nd and 10. I'd like to remind everybody that this is a tobacco-free facility. That means the use of any and all vape and e-pens is strictly prohibited, as well as there is no smoking of any kind permitted on the property. Second down, the G-men are looking to run. Number 4 is going to be the ball carrier. He's looking to get outside. Going to be back down.
I think that was number 39, Dylan Johnson, with the stop for the Spartans. Looks like the G-men are going to try for a field goal here. Kick is up and no good. That's going to end the first half of play here today. Stick around as we'll have our cheerleaders take the field for their halftime shows.
Yeah, you just have to go around.
All right, so I'll take the football.
2024 varsity cheerleaders. First up, we have Elise, Riley J, Ava K, Zaley, Abby, Aubrey, Mackenzie, Brooklyn, Mariana, Gabby, Ava R, Riley R, Adrena, Taylor,
yeah!
Aubrey,
woo!
And Cadence.
Go! The Spartans are back and better than before. The red, gray, and white, we're ready to soar. Confident and clean, we can't be beat. We're loud and proud, we won't take defeat.
All right, let's hear it one more time for our cheerleaders. Nice job, ladies. We will have our 50-50 going around one more time in the third quarter. The winner of the 50-50 will be drawn in the fourth quarter. Our concession stand is still open. We've got hot food, cold drinks. Now you can still have a few ices in there if you get really warm. Want to come cool off at the concession stand. Thank everybody for coming out today. Thank all of our volunteers and our officials for being here. It's been a great day of football. It's a beautiful day out. Hopefully we get a few more weeks of this. Spartans won the toss, so they're going to start with the football for the second half. Clean snap, number 15 is looking to run. He's going to be brought down in the backfield. Going to bring up second down for the Spartans. I'd like to thank our sponsors one more time today. Without their help, we'd not have a lot of the things that we have out here, so we'd like to thank Twin Peaks Roofing, Uncle Tito's Mexican Grill, Shelly's Hair and Nail Salon, Pressler Meats, and Soap City Car Wash. We appreciate all the support this season. On second down, Spartans are looking to hand it off. It's number zero, Gage Howell's going to be the ball carrier, but he was met in the backfield before he even got the ball. He's going to be dropped. Going to bring up third down for the Spartans. Third down, Spartans are looking to pass the ball. Passes up and off the hands of number 24. So that pass is going to fall incomplete. Bring up fourth down to the Spartans. On fourth down, the Spartans are going to punt the football. Number 35, Kate Hicks, the punter for the Spartans. Number 35's punt is up, and it is caught by number 76 for the D-men. Gainesville's going to take over the football. They'll have first and 10 from the Spartan 36-yard line, 37-yard line. First down, G-men are looking to run the football. Number 21 is going to be the ball carrier. He's got some room to run. He's being chased by a couple of Spartans, and he's going to be brought down by number 7, Blake Stewart. G-men are going to have first and goal from the Spartan 4. Clean snap for the G-men, looking to run it in. And they're going to get in for a Garrettsville touchdown. Eric's going to try for the extra point, huh? Kicking is up. And it is good. That extra 20 points is going to be good for 2 points. Spartans are going to take over the football. They'll have first and 10 from their own 35. Snap for the Spartans who are looking to pass on first down. Pass is up on top by number 35. He's got the number one. He is up to 10, 15, 10, 5. And he is in for a strong touchdown. Offense. Let's see if the defense can get a stop here. Number 35. Finally caught up by a few Spartans, but that's a long run for the G-men. Snap for the G-man. Looks like number 21 is going to be the ball carrier, trying to weave his way through some traffic. Looks like he stopped just short.
and snap to the G-man, looking to run straight ahead, but met immediately. Looked like number 31, Ozias Tupas, in for the Spartans on the stop. Brings up second down. Second down, G-men are looking to run. And they're going to get in for a good school touchdown. Attempt there for passes up and caught. That's going to be good for 2 points. Spartan offense is going to take the field. They'll have first and 10 from their own 35. Just a reminder, our 50-50 winner will be drawn in the fourth quarter of today's game. Clean snap for the Spartans, number 15 passes up and through the hands. That pass is going to be incomplete in the second down. If you're looking to keep up to date on offense Spartan youth football, you can visit us online at SpartanYFC.com or follow us on our Facebook page at Spartan Youth Football and Cheer. Number 15, ball carrier for the Spartans, he's met in the backfield. Who's tackled for a loss? That's going to bring up 3rd and 12 for the Spartans. Clean snap to the Spartans. Number 15's pass is up and deflected. It's going to bring up 4th down for the Spartans. Down, the Spartans are going to punt the football.
Same defense I just had in.
Yeah, she just come back out with the right thing.
Punt is up. End of the third quarter.
Water.
Just a reminder that this is a non-smoking facility. The use of any and all tobacco products, including all vape and e-pens, is strictly prohibited. We have trash cans located throughout the facility, so please make sure that any trash is ending up in the receptacles. Our concession stand is going to start winding down here, so if you're hungry or thirsty or you want to cool off with something sweet, come see us at the concession stand.
Notifications off.
Huh?
So you might want to
turn your notifications off.
Oh, yeah, everything's off.
I'll see you tomorrow. Hey, snap, the Bears players who's looking to run the football. Number 8, the ball player. He's going to be dropped down by number 39, Jordan Johnson, for the starting with the tackle. Jordan Lindsay's starting on the field. Let's see if our Spartan team walks off on his own power. So after the play, Garrettsville's going to have 1st and 10 from the Spartan 28-yard line. And snap for the email number 76 is into the ball carrier. Looks like that was number 2, Finn Hurst, with the tackle for the Spartans. Clean snap for the G-men who are looking to get to the edge. Looks like we have a very slow touchdown. Spartans are going to take over the football. They'll have 1st and 10 from their own 35. Spartans number 15 will complete it, and he's going to be dropping it back to the ball coming loose. Spartans are able to jump on it.
Looks like a handoff to number zero, Gage Howell for the Spartans. Spartans looking to hand it off. It's number zero, Gage Howell, going to stumble forward for you. Looks like no gain on the play. It's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth down, the Spartans are going to punt. Number two, Finn Hurst with the punt for the Spartans. If I could get my 50-50 seller to come back to the concession stand so we can draw our winner before the game's over.
Let's line up.
Looks like that's going to be the end of our ball game. We have a final score of Springfield Spartans 8, Barrettsville Jayhawks 43. I'd like to thank everybody for coming out today. Let's give a big round of applause for all of our football players and cheerleaders out here today.
Good luck.